Let us look at this classroom. The teacher draws a line on the floor using chalk and asks all the students to stand 3 feet away from this line. Let us observe what happens. So, the students end up forming a line. Now, why does that happen? You can consider all these students as points. So, this is a collection of points, and all these points are satisfying one condition, which is that they are standing 3 feet away from this line which is there on the floor. So what we see is, this is the path, or this is the collection of all such points that are at a fixed distance, 3 feet. So all these are points which are 3 feet away from this line. And what do you get? So the locus of all such points gives me nothing but a line which is parallel to the line which we already had. So we get a line parallel to it and distance 3 feet away from this, because this is what we were told. We had to stand 3 feet away from that line. So the locus of all such points that are a fixed distance d away from this line L gives you a straight line which is parallel to this line L. So this is what the locus of all points at a fixed distance away from a line is. That is a straight line which would be parallel to the line L and a fixed distance away from it. Now let us look at this. Let us say that the teacher now draws a line in the middle of the classroom. He draws it on the floor in the middle of the classroom and again gives the same instruction, that is to stand 3 feet away from this line. So this is what we get. That is, all these students stand 3 feet away from this line. Now if these students are considered as points, what are you getting? That all points are moving 3 feet away from this line. So in turn, what we get? We get two lines, two straight lines parallel to this line. When all the points move 3 feet away from a fixed line, so 3 feet on both these sides, we get two parallel lines which are parallel to this given line L. That is, the locus of all such points that are at a fixed distance d away from this line on either sides gives you a straight line on either side which is at a fixed distance away from this line L, and all these lines are parallel. So you get a pair of parallel lines on either side a fixed distance d away from this line which we were already given. So this is what the locus is from a line, a fixed distance away from a fixed line. Now let's look at this. This is a road here, and you can observe that this white line is in the middle of the road. That is, if the road is say 2D apart, then this is D because it is the midway, and this distance is also D. Further, what you can see is that these two lines of the road are parallel. So when you have two parallel lines and you want to find the locus of all such points that are equal distance from these two lines, so gives you this line which is on the middle of the road. So this line is nothing but equal distance away from both these lines of the road. Equal distance away from two parallel lines gives me what? Another line. This is the third line which is again parallel to both these lines. So what we get is, when you have two parallel lines and you want to find locus of all such points which are equidistant from these two parallel lines, you get another line equidistant, so both the sides distance is the same, which is say D. So it is equidistant from both these lines and you get a parallel line. So this line in turn is a straight line, equidistant from both the lines and parallel also to both these lines. Now, have you ever observed a moving train? Look at the center of this wheel. While this train is moving, observe just this point, which is the center of the wheel. So the train is moving on this straight line track. So if you observe this line, you get this line, that is locus of all points which the center of this wheel is forming while this train is moving on this straight line track. Now what is this distance? You can see that the center of the wheel, this is the radius of the wheel. This r is the radius of the wheel, which is the distance between these two lines. So what you get is a parallel line to the straight line track, which is a fixed distance r away from this line. And this r is nothing but the radius of the wheel. So the locus of the center of the wheel, which moves on this straight line track, what is that locus? You get a straight line again, which is a fixed distance away from this straight line track, and this distance is equal to the radius of this wheel. So this is what the locus is.